We want to evaluate this inverse trig expression in both degrees and radians. We're given arc secant of -2, which means this is equal to some angle theta that has a secant function value of -2, or if we want, -2/1. But there's an infinite number of angles that have a secant function value of -2, and that's why it's important that we know the output or range for the arc secant function. This angle theta must be in the open interval from 0 degrees to 180 degrees, or in radians, theta must be on the open interval from 0 to pi radians. And again, this equation means that secant theta must equal -2, which I'm going to write as -2/1. Now in this form, it's hard to recognize what common angle would have a secant function value of -2/1. So from here, it's helpful to remember that secant theta and cosine theta are reciprocals of one another. Cosine theta is equal to the ratio of the length of the adjacent side of a right triangle to the hypotenuse, while secant theta is equal to the ratio of the length of the hypotenuse to the length of the adjacent side. Which means that if secant theta is equal to -2/1, then cosine theta is equal to -1/2. So if we ignore this negative sign for a moment, having a cosine function value of -1/2 should remind us of a 30, 60, 90 right triangle. So if this is 30 degrees, this is 60 degrees, and this is 90, remember we can label the short leg 1, the hypotenuse 2, and the longer leg, square root 3. Notice how the cosine of the 60 degree angle would be equal to +1/+2. So even though it's the wrong sign, it does tell us that this angle here would have a reference angle of 60 degrees, or would have a 60 degree reference triangle. So now if I go back and take a look at the output of the arc secant function, we know the initial side must be along the positive x-axis. And if the angle is in this interval, it must terminate somewhere from here to here. And since the cosine function value is negative, we know we must be in the second quadrant. So what we'll do is sketch a 60 degree reference angle in the second quadrant, which would look something like this. This is 60 degrees. Therefore, our angle theta would be the angle that starts here and stops here, which would be 90 + 30, or 120 degrees. Notice if we were to sketch the reference triangle by dropping a perpendicular here, this leg here would be -1 because we're in the second quadrant. The hypotenuse would be 2, and this leg here would be square root of 3. But notice how the cosine of this angle does have a cosine function value of -1/2. So again, our angle theta is equal to 120 degrees. If we want this in radians, we would multiply by pi divided by 180 degrees. There are 2 60s in 120 and 3 60s in 180. So in radians, we have 2π/3 radians. As a last resort, we could use the calculator, but there's not going to be an arc secant or inverse secant button. So again, we'd have to make the connection that since cosine theta is equal to -1/2, then inverse cosine or arc cosine of -1/2 would be equal to our angle theta. So let's go ahead and verify this on the calculator as well. The first thing we want to do is check our mode. We want to do this in degrees because if we have it in radian mode, it's not going to leave the answer in terms of pi, so it'd be hard to recognize what angle that would be. So we have it in degree mode. We'll go back to the home screen. Now if we press secant cosine, this brings up inverse cosine. We'll type in -1/2. And this does verify your answer is correct, 120 degrees. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.